Good evening, and thank you to all of the board members for allowing McGinnis School to have our little presentation for you this evening. We appreciate it. For most educators, Harry Wong is a name that we all know. He is someone who is not only an educator, but a speaker, an author, and he's written some books that have really inspired a lot of us to be better teachers. I was lucky enough when I was a student at Kane to hear him speak. And one of the things that Harry Wong tries to instill in incoming teachers is that we should steal. We should all be thieves. We should steal from each other. That the ideas are out there and that all we need to do is to find them. I had forgotten that piece of advice. I'd sort of tucked it away until we all at McGinnis were introduced to Instructional Rounds. And I stand here before you today admitting that I am now a thief. Today, I actually stole an idea that I had seen in Gabriella Puglisi's room for cards that would introduce topics, and the kids go over and they pick a card and they go over to their desk and they write a number and they are able to use that prompt for writing. I now have my own set of laminated cards in my room, something that I had seen in Ms. Puglisi's room, just loved the idea of, and now I have stolen that. For those of you who don't know what instructional rounds are, very briefly, they're intended to help all of us as teachers and as educators to develop a shared understanding of what high quality lessons look like, what high quality instruction looks like in the classroom. It's inspired by medical rounds, how doctors would use it in hospital settings. And what we did as a group was we visited other classrooms during their instructional time in an effort to see their methodologies in action. And in turn, had our rooms visited by a group who would then look at the methodologies that we were using. We would then go back into the conference room and, using post-its and the board, come up with ways that we saw children interacting in classrooms with each other, ways that teachers were interacting with their students, ways that children were working independently, but independently in a successful manner, not just sort of sitting off by themselves, but knowing what to do in a classroom and knowing what tools were available to them. Simply, it was an incredible way to, in a very non-judgmental way, walk from room to room and see how others are helping their children and perhaps learn from them and steal from them the ideas that we now call our gems. So another teacher from our building, I'm an seventh and eighth grade language arts teacher, Edgardo Vazquez, who is also a teacher here in the building, but is across the street at Peterson School with a fifth grade science and math class, also did the rounds and is going to briefly tell you about his experience. And then we have a little snippet of some of the gems that we have found at McGinnis School.
Good evening, everyone. From my first experience when we did the instruction rounds, I would not kid to you, I was scared to death. And so were the students. They were terrified, because they saw a number of group of people come into the classroom. They're saying to themselves, why are all these people here? But as they got to see what it was all about, then the students began to loosen up themselves. And what we came to find out, the teachers, our colleagues, that we were within the same area within each content, whether it was math or science. And the lesson that each of us did, we got to see it in a different way being taught. So, for example, the same lesson that I was teaching, I saw one of my colleagues, she did the same exact lesson, but in a Simon Says way. And the kids were all engaged, they were participating, they were excited and enthusiastic within the lesson. So I tried it 2 days later, and the same result happened within my classroom. The kids were able to get the mathematical concepts of measurements. When I first taught it, they were having difficulty understanding at first. Then one of my colleagues came to me, and what she saw in my classroom, where we're using whiteboards that the students get to use, and they, when they're working on an open-ended question, because we see that that's where they're struggling the most, in the math area. when it comes to the quizzes, tests, and even on the New Jersey Ask, they're struggling with open-ended constructive response questions. And the whiteboard helps them to answer three questions. What is it that they're asking me? What information do I have within this word problem? How can I use this information to solve the problem? Once they're able to answer those three questions, they're able to work out the problem, not only show the work, but able to explain more clearly what the process was. And I already had a couple of teachers that came back to my room and says, where did you get this material? And I was happy to tell them, I says, well, the good thing about it is it's part of the new component that we, the fifth graders, are gonna be using with Go Math for next year, because this aligns to the new national core standards. So the teachers were excited, and I've been sharing my materials and what I've been doing, what's been working in my class with my colleagues, and vice versa. There hasn't been a lunch period or a prep period that we're not continuing to talk to each other, even through the hallways. That we even had Dr. Garcia, we didn't even realize that we were speaking in the hallways, we were walking, and she says, I'm loving what I'm hearing. So hearing that from our own principal gave us more enthusiasm to say, you know what, we're doing is starting to finally show results within the teachers, that we're building collaboration, we're building unity, that there's not even a moment that in the evening or on the weekends, we're not texting or calling each other or emailing each other with information about what we're using in our classroom, what's working and what's not working. And there's now a new commonality all across the board within our own fifth grade team. It's brought us to be a more tight-knit family. And we love it now because we're sharing so many ideas and we're getting to see what's working for us and what's not working, what we could do to tweak it to make it better for our students and the lessons for them to be more engaged. Thank you.
Credit for that movie. Chris Dobrowolski and Lindsey Tisch, who are our computer teachers here in the building, put this wonderful piece together. I won't steal credit for that. I'll steal a lot, but I won't steal credit for that. Just to conclude, if you walk into any school in Perth Amboy, you'll see adults who deeply care about kids. We all do. We're doing the best we can every day to help them learn. And we ask of ourselves today to do that with rigor, to do that with a higher expectation, using critical thinking skills, not to simply go with rote memorization and the things that perhaps a lot of us saw when we were children. This process is difficult, and we need to share dialogue, we need to observe each other, we need to discuss, analyze, we need to learn, and us, the teachers, need to teach each other. So I'm a thief, I admit it, and I can only hope that during instructional rounds, someone found something in my classroom that they wanted to steal. Thank you so much for your time, and I hope we'll be able to present again.